Nobody likes onions. The show everyone loves to hate.
Special Tuesday show. We don't usually do a Tuesday show, but today we're doing a Tuesday show because guess what? Daddy's on a flight to San Antone tomorrow night. Six shows. Why don't you come on out? Hi, everybody. My name's Patrick. I'm a comedian. I kind of tell jokes. I kind of talk about my shits. It's a combo show. One day you'll hear jokes. Jokes? That was supposed to be a word. It sounds like jokes. And also, I'll talk about my shits. Had a good one today. Tell you about it later. Supposed to hit the music, the mark. Wasn't smooth. Not always a good show. Kicking off this show how I've kicked them off since I returned from Florida. 5 minutes of shame staring at me for gaining back about 20 pounds while I was in Florida. 5 seconds of it. Have a look at my big titted body. God, I'm disgusting. Thank you for tuning in. We are taking phone calls. Today, 323-825-4990. I did go to the gym yesterday. I did not go today. I am a giant piece of shit. Comedian Erik Myers is here. Hi, Erik. Welcome to the show. Jesus.
I think you look good.
No. That's what you don't understand.
What? Well, take your shirt off. I can't see.
Oh, God. Why would
you're
we
have... You're hidden behind this table.
We don't have 30 minutes
you're
to do that
teasing.
Shit.
You're teasing me, and I don't like it.
No, I lost like 45 pounds earlier this year. I had a personal trainer. I was gymming 5 days a week.
Yeah.
And then I went to Europe for a month, and I just lived the way the Europeans fish and chipped it up. And no, that's not true. I ate Burger King over there because it's the only tolerable thing for a palate.
Right.
And then I came back, and I literally ate everything I missed in the United States. Then I went to Florida. I was working in Florida for 3 fucking weeks, and I ate everything in Florida I missed. Publix subs,
oh my
Beef
God.
O'Brady's wings. Oh like, I went God. To all the places.
Publix subs are the shit.
The best.
But like, hey, wait, like, because my one friend stopped drinking soda and he lost like 20 pounds.
Yeah.
How much of it is just like your diet? How
soda,
much
is- I got to get off. I've been drinking Diet Coke like a goddamn madman, like I had an IV of it.
Yeah.
Chris Cope, comedian Chris Cope, is also sitting what in. Up? He's sitting. You got to get right on that mic like a dick, man.
What's up?
What up?
You see that? Now he had a voice.
So what's your guilty pleasure?
Get it,
do you eat one thing?
What's
eat one
my guilty pleasure?
Like, because I'm a drug addict in recovery. So like, when you
let's
eat,
talk about it. No.
When you eat, like, do you feel like is it similar to a drug addict when you relapse? Like, do you feel ashamed of yourself? You eat like a cookie.
Oh yeah,
or, like,
but then the shame doesn't
dough?
The shame drive you to do more?
Yeah.
It's like, yo, yeah. You know what makes me feel better when I'm ashamed? Pizza.
Right.
You know
right.
What makes me ashamed? Pizza. You know what makes me feel better when I'm ashamed? Pizza. It's just a cycle.
But are you like guilty while you're eating it? Are you like, oh, fuck, I suck? Or
maybe.
Are you, like, are you eating? You're like, oh, my God, yes, yes, yes. And then afterwards, you're like, ugh.
Do you know what? Like, even afterwards, like, you ever go to like, you have a breakdown or this happens on the road a lot. It's fucking 1 a.m.
Yeah.
You were starving. You didn't eat before your shows or whatever. And now you have to eat. And it's like, only thing open, McDonald's. And you go there and you do like, dude, I'll get like 2 double cheeseburgers.
Yeah.
Like, that's my shit.
Yeah.
And then a drink and I'm good. But like, you eat it and then you just go like, I can't do it. Now, how old are you? Like, I just can't do it. Yeah, I'm 33. I can't do it.
Yeah.
My body goes like, what are you doing?
It's like saturated and like, you just, it's
you
just,
unwrap
it's like
it and it's shiny. It's shiny.
It's awful.
Not.
It's a
you closer. You gotta get right. You gotta yell into it.
You put McDonald's Chris? Outside and come back the next day.
Oh, there we go.
It'll look exactly the same. McDonald's is disgusting.
They did it for a year. Somebody left it on the, put a Happy Meal. And oh no, they got a Happy Meal, didn't open it. Put it on the shelf for a year. Opened it up, it looked exactly the same as the day. Like, the fries looked fine. The burger looked... They unwrapped
that's
it, and
disgusting.
I swear to God, it was like...
There's no mold on it?
No.
How did it taste?
I don't think they ate it.
What?
How many minutes in the microwave would that need before you would feel comfortable swallowing?
You can't put McDonald's in the microwave.
Yes, you can.
It turns to straight shit.
McDonald's cheeseburger.
Are you out of your mind?
The burger gets hard. It's hard.
You're refrigerating and reheating McDonald's?
That's how lazy I get on the road. I will stock up in surplus Mickey D's.
The fries reheated are never the same.
No, the fries taste like shit when they're reheated. But you get
any fries. You can't reheat fries.
Yeah, you're not. It's a fried item. You can't really reheat a fried item.
You're telling me you microwave the burger.
I will, yeah.
A Big Mac?
No, like a single cheeseburger.
No lettuce.
Of course not.
Pickles, though. No.
Lettuce.
Whatever comes on the standard cheeseburger.
But the pickles.
I will put it in the microwave.
You're going to get a piping hot pickle on your tongue.
I don't mind it.
Whoa.
I got to.
Those are good.
Chris Gopes loves a piping hot pickle.
You guys
want to
get McDonald's after this?
No. I'm trying to be a health nut.
I went to the gym today, too, mister.
McDonald's is
I didn't today.
Listen, McDonald's is like Target here. You ever go to Target and you're like...
No.
No, listen. You go to Target, you're like, I need a washcloth, and you end up spending like $800 just because you keep picking shit up. McDonald's, I went in there for one hamburger yesterday and I spent $10.
You don't realize how much stuff your home doesn't have until you're at a Target. You're like, oh.
I can't stop putting shit in the cart.
I needed a Shifaro.
No, yeah. Like, you Shifaro. Don't even realize that your kitchen doesn't have like these 13 appliances that are necessary to complete. I want the Target kitchen, the one they like set up.
I know.
As a model. Or IKEA. You ever go to IKEA? Like, I should just fucking live here.
I should live there. It looks so nice.
It's so fucking nice.
I've never been to an IKEA, son.
How have you never been to an IKEA?
I just moved
the
here.
Food at the IKEA is fucking sick.
You just moved here. They're everywhere.
I don't fucking know. I'm white trash. We get our stuff at garage sales and side of the road.
Dude, IKEA is like Sweden's garage sale. It's pretty amazing.
It. Chris is my roommate, and he got this bookshelf, and I'm putting it together. Dude, it took me an hour and a half. I've screwed two things together. I'm not even sure if they're supposed to be
together. How are you two roommates? This makes no sense.
Well, you see, he was homeless.
Oh, yeah. Well, now it's coming together.
We have an understanding. Chris houses me, and I pretend like I'm going to get him gigs at Ha Ha.
Oh, sweet. At Ha Ha?
At the Ha Ha. I got him at Ha Ha in exchange for
God, if you need a fucking liaison to get you up at Ha Ha, things ain't going well, Chris.
Things are going just fine. Don't worry.
That ain't good. Oh, God. Can you talk to Jack for me? I don't know.
Put in a word for Terry.
Can I stay here? That's the going rate.
Oh yeah, you're trying to you're shopping new homes.
You got to
Eric pays.
You got to bathe and feed me.
Eric pays. Good.
I got. We got to talk about this. Some listener sent me this in the mail. This is a flying fuck helicopter.
That is cool.
Okay.
I like
it. I don't give a flying fuck.
So this is a remote control helicopter.
Does it really work?
We're gonna find out.
Oh my god.
Let me go to our wide cam. Let me go to our wide studio cam. We're gonna go inside and play with it.
I want to play with it.
I want to find out. I charged it before the show. It's got a blue blinking beacon. Oh, shit.
Oh, fuck. That is so cool.
Oh, shit.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Chris almost.
I will never forget this.
It can ride itself. Hold on. Let's see.
That thing is so fucking cool. How high does it go? Let's take it out.
I don't know.
After the show,
let's take it outside and then lose it.
Yeah, let's make sure it just goes to the neighbors
right into
and
traffic.
Beyond.
No, let's see how high up it goes.
Oh, God.
The carnage. Look at the carnage.
Does it steer okay?
Yeah, no, it's steering like shit.
It's not aerodynamic. It's the word fuck with a motor attached to it.
It's like a boomerang.
It's not flying. It's not an SR-71.
It does have.
It's a goddamn kid's toy.
It does have steering controls. Why does it have those?
I want to play with it now.
They're using the same motor.
Hold on. I got one more flight. I got one more.
It's the
shit.
It's the same thing. So,
Patrick, I want to play with it.
The fuck?
Oh yeah! If I had a nickel,
you'd have 10 cents.
How do I do it?
You'd have 10 cents, Patrick.
Oh,
how do I do it?
It's forward, but you just lightly. You gotta, you gotta tap it.
I'm sending it out of the room.
You gotta tap it. You can't just,
God.
Oh, great.
This is fucking radical. Where'd it go?
You're out of your.
Oh my god! It's broken.
No, it didn't.
That thing's broken.
It didn't break. Wait, it's coming up now. Oh my god! What if I landed this exactly on the table where it was?
Oh yeah, you'd be brilliant. You'd be one of the best.
I'd buy you another chili dog.
Wait, I can't. How does it go over? It won't come to me.
No, it won't come. It won't do anything.
Woman.
It's a flying word.
It's a woman.
Well, it should move left to right.
No,
really
it's not
angry.
Aerodynamic. It doesn't have a rudder to steer.
Well, then what's the point of it?
It's a fucking
gag.
Wait,
go! Oh my god! It went
no, hard. It's in the bathroom now.
All right.
You're out of your fucking mind.
You gotta go get it. I gotta turn the charger off. It's expensive.
I'm sorry.
You gotta go grab it.
Yeah.
You can't just fucking lose my toys in the neighbor's yard and then leave, Eric. You got to go get it. Okay, that's how we play around here. Oh, sorry, I threw your frisbee over the fence. Talk to you later. Call me when you have a frisbee. You ever have that friend?
Yeah.
Like, you lost my shit, and now you don't want to hang because I don't have my shit.
My friend, I used to lend him my Nintendo games, and he'd say he lost them. And I fuck it. And people were like, we were playing DuckTales over at Matt's house. And I'm like, that's my DuckTales. And
he'd DuckTales?
On Nintendo. You never played DuckTales?
DuckTales.
Woo!
DuckTales, they had Rescue Rangers.
No, nobody ever played that.
Please.
That my parents let me play with guns.
So listen to this. I picked up a week in San Antonio opening for a MetaMed.
Oh, very cool.
Who's very funny, which I'm happy about. And I was like, cool, I'll do the week work before the Comedy Central competition. I'll be polished. I'm going to, you know, tighten up these bits, cram a few more little one-liners in.
The what competition?
The Comedy Central competition.
I'm sorry.
We'll talk about it. We'll talk about it.
I couldn't hear you.
We'll talk about it. We'll talk about, well, okay. Or is the bit done?
No. I'm going to milk this for 10
listen
minutes.
Listen to this. So I'm headlining at, there's two clubs in San Antonio run by the same company. LOL Comedy Club and River Center Comedy Club.
Oh.
Okay. I'm featuring for a MetaMed. This was a last minute thing like 2 weeks ago, next week. But I'm headlining there in January. Okay. This is the fucking message I get from them yesterday. And this is and I've featured this club before, but I've never headlined. I'm headlining for the first time in January.
All right.
Features are welcome to sell merchandise, which is good because they pay shit for features. They paid jack shit.
Yeah, I worked it once like 3 years ago.
Are they going to hear this?
Are you in that state of your career where you're afraid of people still?
Yes!
Oh, God.
Yes!
You're 33. You got to get over this shit.
No! All right.
This is a show where we just tell it like it is. I'm not bad-mouthing anybody. The club is fantastic. They don't give comics free food and beer, which I find ridiculous in this day and age.
They don't give you even
when
one
you're,
free
when
drink?
You're not even paying $100 a show to your features. Regardless... Look, those are just facts. I'm not trying to start a fight. That's just facts.
They put you up, yeah?
Oh, yeah. They give you a condo. It's pretty sweet. I get a hotel because daddy needs Wi-Fi.
I like how condos never have fucking Wi-Fi.
Or cable. It's like, nah, you're a rat, right? You can just live in a cage till we let you out to run on your wheel.
Why do comedy condos always have a VCR? I'm like, you have not got a goddamn DVD player in the last 20
years. Oh, yeah. They have a VCR or they have that god-awful... There's always... First of all, every comedy condo has the big TV and the little TV on top of it.
The little TV.
That's not... I'm not making that up. Every condo has like the big screen, old big
and the
screen.
Little one. Yeah.
Tampa
little
side, one. Yeah, Tampa Side Splitters has the exact same thing. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
And the mattresses are always flat as a pancake.
I'm the like, sheets take are the disgusting.
Yeah. You know, like 1,000 comics have fucked on that mattress.
And even if they haven't, they jizzed all over
it. Oh, I'm making
fucking...
a point to jizz on every bed. I'm like, I'm going to bleed.
Yeah, dude.
That's gross. That's why I don't stay there.
You can see Gary Menke's ass print.
I don't know where you're at in your career. I just don't do condos. Like, if you don't give me one, fine. I got enough fucking cheddared, and I sell enough shirts to make that kind of happen on Priceline. But I get a hotel.
I can't afford that.
Dude, I can't. I can't. I'm a fancy guy. I live in a pod castle.
Yeah. Hey, if you can afford it, do it.
I can't.
Do it.
But I got credit cards from back when I had a day job. And I will redline this life of mine.
Bro, I'm all for comedians getting what, because I know how hard it, I know how shitty the pay is.
Well, so that's
deserve,
not,
comedians deserve.
So that's not even the point.
More.
The point is, on this fucking letter of confirmation I get, I swear to baby Jesus, it says, comedians are allowed to sell merch. Which I sell a lot of merch. I sell CDs and shirts.
What are your shirts?
And I do pretty. I'm not giving away. You got to come to a show. You know, because it's one of my whole bits spelled out.
Okay.
Just kidding. That would be gay. Don't ever buy a shirt from a comedian where he wrote out one of his bits. Or there's like a sentence and dot, 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 and the joke's on the back. Throw that away. Immediately.
My shirt sucks worse than yours. I'm very sure it does.
Oh, yeah. Mine's real fly.
Mine's horrid. I'm embarrassed to sell that motherfucker, but I have 50 of them.
My shirt says WT fuck.
WT fuck.
Across the front.
That's cool.
And it sells with these hip kids.
Yeah.
Okay. That's all you need. And a logo on the back. I have my logo on website on the back. Small up on the shoulder. Okay? Very fashionable, because I know what girls like to shove their tits in.
Do you have women's and men's?
Yes.
You have the halter top thing? Or the tank? The girls' tee?
It's just the girls' cut, yeah.
That's what I wear.
Of course it is. Yeah, V-neck.
I'm hilarious on this podcast.
They wrote, features are welcome to sell merchandise, but you can't promote it on stage during your show.
What?
What?
Can you believe
are
that?
Are you fucking
what?
Kidding?
That's a real line.
Well, how are you supposed to sell it?
They didn't tell me that when I worked there.
No, right. Like I said, I've worked this club
just
before.
Just do it by accident and be like, oh, I'm sorry, I forgot.
I worked this club before. I never heard that rule.
I've
and
never
now
heard
it's a
that
rule. And somebody, I was talking to somebody and they were like, why is that a big deal? And I go, here's why it's a big deal. A, I reinforce this joke two or three times in my set. Then I hold up the shirt. Then they go ape shit and go, oh my God, we got to get one of those shirts. Then when I'm walking out, they see me selling stuff and go, oh, right, he has those shirts.
Right.
And a line
yeah,
for
yeah, that's so okay? stupid.
If I can't promote it on stage, I have to grab people as they go out and do a pitch to all the people individually. And if one person stops to buy one, I have to engage with them. Now I'm losing other sales because people are going by. A line doesn't
form. That just cost you $200-$300. That just cost you money.
Yeah. A line doesn't form.
No.
Yeah.
Because they don't know what you have.
But the headliner can promote his.
Of course.
So shouldn't it be up to the headliner the date of the show? That's how it usually
is. I'm going to talk to a Meta Med, and I've never worked with him. I doubt he even sells anything.
He's cool as shit.
But I know he's, yeah, I know he's funny and real. I know he's not a piece of shit. But, yeah,
do
I don't
it
know.
Anyways.
I might just
what the
do
fuck
it.
Are they
yeah,
going to say?
I think I'm just going
to
go up and do
just
it.
Just say you forgot. All you got to say is, oops, on my bad.
But my point is, I have a headline date there in January. I don't want them to be like, oh, fuck that. You were going to pull your... But it's also like, do you understand that's all, like, I don't make money from you. They're paying me like $600. My ticket's $400. I got a hotel for $300.
Yeah, you need to sell merch. Otherwise,
I have to sell merch or I don't make money.
But that they might not invite you back as the headliner.
I already have a date there and I've had it for 6 months.
Yeah,
but I don't know they're going to
take the date.
What so, I mean, sincerely, who's going to sit there and watch your set and go, oh, he did that. He's not coming back.
Yeah, I just
who's
don't
that
get
person? Because what manager at a comedy club ever pays a fucking
something
attention to what
you're
doing?
Something had to happen
doing?
Where one headliner complained or some shit.
If they tell you not to, though, and you do it, you're...
If they tell me not to, but what if I just didn't read that in the email?
Yeah. I mean, all you got to say is I missed that part.
Well, then you'll do it for one show.
They're not going to dig up this pod.
I mean, it's up to you. I mean, you run the risk of them getting mad, but that's up to you.
Yeah, but, I'm about to be on a Comedy Central star. So, you know, that's their loss.
That's true, buddy. That's true.
Because when you want me, if you cancel that headliner date for the price I agreed, and then I get on Comedy Central, and you're going to want me back, the price is going up.
I did a show at Universal Studios one time for Bonkers. And
quit bragging.
Don't
talk about Michael Jackson. Don't talk about...
Oh, when that little old lady come in and be like, here are the words you can't say. And
yeah.
She's like, cunt, pussy. I'm like, dude, it was the funniest thing. They get 10% of the merchandise sold. I sold one...
Who gets that? Universal?
I don't know exactly. I forget.
Joe?
Probably Joe.
Joe.
I sold one CD for $10. I'm like, you want me to give you $1? Universal? Are you hurting that bad for money? It was ridiculous.
Somebody's got to pay to keep all these
lights
on.
Was that City Walk?
Yeah.
I did that when Kobe Bryant was in the audience. And they're like, you cannot mention, look at, acknowledge Kobe's presence.
Oh, fuck
you. Oh, cool. That sounds like a fun show.
Yeah, I was on eggshells. And I think as I kept on making eye contact with him, because in a sea of people, you see Kobe fucking Bryant. You're like, you know?
And plus, you know, you can't say.
No, and this was like, this was literally maybe 6 months after he got done raping people. So, I mean, I wanted to talk to him, but.
Oh, God, that would have been a disaster.
No, I would, yeah.
Oh, God, that sounds like a light, fun show.
Yeah.
Don't make eye contact or look at this
people
region.
People rape you. How come Chris is on both cameras and I'm not on one?
I had him
I'm
on,
that big.
I had him on, you were that on big. One. You guys want to split it? There you go. You guys, look.
My name
I'm
is
the
Ego
star
Ma-
of the show.
My name is Ego Meyer.
You didn't even tell
show.
Me you were bringing him. You know how rude that is to just show up at a dude's house with another dude?
Yeah, what if we were going to fuck?
Much less a big dude. I can't even, what if I couldn't accommodate?
Hey.
Look at that face. He brings sunshine and happiness to all.
I thought you were going to remember me.
I thought
I could
it would
have
cheer
sworn
you up.
The more I look at you, the more you remind me of a young me. How old are you?
I'm fucking like 2 years younger than you. Are you
he's
son
29.
Of a
god? He looks so baby.
Why do you have a taser right there?
Just in case people get out of line.
Can I play with your? Can I?
No, Christ! Please do not give him that taser.
Please finish that sentence.
Can I play with your taser?
Oh God, that wasn't any better than what I imagined.
Let me play with your taser, and I'll play with something else.
I brought
I promise.
Chris to brighten
your day. People get out of line. We just
zap him. Zap him with it.
I've done my balls. I've done.
No, you haven't.
You never done like your finger on one of these?
No.
It hurts like a motherfucker.
No, it does. Like your finger?
I've had heart issues, so please don't zap me.
Well, let's keep it nice and friendly.
You put it on your bare balls? Yeah. Like your jeans?
No, I touch my balls too.
How much alcohol?
You do not touch
your
balls.
I did.
Get the fuck out of here.
We had a guy flop his dick out on the table, and I put it down over his dick like that.
On the show?
Like this, and we tased the fuck
I don't
out
need
of
airplay that bad.
On the show?
Yeah, you want to see video of it?
No.
Okay.
Mm. I actually would kind of like to see
we'll
a guy get his dick taste.
We'll reenact it.
Kiss my
yeah,
ass.
Yeah, Chris, put your cock out.
Man, thank you.
Well, that's great.
All right.
That's great. I don't know how that's a policy, though. Like, no, it's cool if you sell merch. You just can't sell the merch.
Have you ever had a headliner tell you you couldn't sell?
I'm sure.
I've only had one.
You know, I have the luxury. I have the luxury of being pretty big and intimidating, where headliners don't really fucking talk to me.
I don't have that problem.
Oh, I had a headliner, Killer Bees. His wife walks up and was like,
"We're talking about real comics over here."
But you know what? It doesn't.
Now listen.
It's still.
I'm not talking about Comedy Zone headliners. Now listen.
Still work.
Killer Bees. Isn't he like a southern dude?
Yeah, he's old as fuck. He won't let you.
I've never worked with him at all. I don't know him. He sounds like a real fucking loser. Listen, and if you're using a fake name for your comedy, you need to get out. If you, by the way, not fake name, like if you made up a name like Bill Weathers, that's just a normal name, but that's what you want to go by on stage, cool. All you black people with your hip hop rap names.
Bill Weathers.
Yeah,
who's changing their comedy name? My stage name is Bill Weathers.
There's like another comic in LA named Chris Porter that goes by, and it's just like, what are you doing? There's already been a comic named Chris Porter who's way more successful than you. You have to go by something else.
There was a comic in Maryland, not that I'm king shit, but his name was Eric Miser. And people were booking him, and then he changed his name to Eric Frost because of me, because I was so huge in Maryland.
Yeah. I don't imagine you being huge.
I was huge. You do anywhere.
You're a tiny boy.
You do anything in the Inner Harbor, my name.
Do anything in the Inner Harbor, just mumble my name, a crowd will form.
Anywhere on K Street, they know Eric Sean Myers.
I ran into you when you were living in Orlando. That's where I met you.
Yes. Did we meet at a club? Where did we meet?
I'm sure, but it was just one of those guys. When did you start comedy?
May 10th, 2001.
Okay, so you like 2 years.
I did it twice before that.
You're 2 years in before me.
Mm-hmm.
And I just remember people talking about you like, you have to do Eric Myers. You do Eric Myers. He's got this voice.
He got the voice.
Don't you love that when people like, that's how they just classify you though? Like, yeah, I wrote jokes too.
People love the
Because your voice is the most distinct thing.
Yeah, it's distinct. Sometimes I feel like it's too much for the crowd. Like it hurts their ears. Or
it's not as bad as it used to be.
It's not as bad.
It used to be more extreme, I think. When you were young, it used to be faster, more hype.
Was it? It was more annoying.
Beavis-y.
I'm trying to slow it down for the
West. But you know what I mean? I think it was higher pitched and I think it was faster.
Yeah, I'm trying to slow it down for the West Coast because they're a little more chill.
Slow it down for the West Coast.
Because now I had a girl come up to me after the show and she's like, can I give you some advice? I'm like, sure. She's like, don't scream into the microphone. I'm like, I've been doing that for like 12 years.
Yeah, I'm killing with that.
But out here, everybody's so laid back, man, that when you're jumping around, they're like, why is this guy jumping around? So I was like, should I tone it down? Should I do what I'm doing?
I really think we're talking a little bit about the Comedy Central thing before that we're both part of.
I think once you start
second guessing what you do, dude, if you've been doing it for 12 years, it's what you do. And when you start to change it, especially like during a competition, I think you fuck yourself in the head.
I'm not gonna change it for the competition.
Yeah, you can't.
Go up there and kill. That's all you can do.
It's like writing new jokes for the comedy. Like, no. Oh, you know what I'll do? I'll write a fresh new set.
Yeah.
Like, will you?
No.
That'll be great.
What am I going to come up with in 8 days that I haven't come up with in 12 years?
I might just do a roast of all the other competitors during my 7 minutes. How fucking funny would that be?
That would actually be classic.
Kirsten Alberts, a girl. Yeah, right. Nothing else to say about that bitch. You just like systematically go down a list and just tear people apart. This is what. Now you say you can't trash talk people.
I'm not trash talking people.
No.
I don't know any of the people.
See, that's how defensive he is. I just go. Now you said you don't trash talk people. I'm not doing it right now. You're safe. You're new to LA.
I'm too new. No, I don't. I'm not gonna trash. Why are you trash talking?
I'm not trash talking. I was saying.
I don't even know.
I don't know any of the comics on mine.
I don't know any of the comics on mine.
And I think it would just be so funny to make videos just being like, "Who's this piece of shit with the hair?" You know what I mean? And it just doesn't mean anything. But it's just like make fun of their hair, make fun of their face.
You do what you want.
No, I'm saying, but nobody's doing that.
Don't make fun of me. I'm sensitive.
You're not in my competition yet.
I'll see you in New York.
You guys will actually never be in competition.
Yeah, New York.
Well, no, but you said it's more of a showcase in New York.
Yeah, but there's still one defined winner they're going to pick online.
Okay. Yeah, there's one defined
winner. I don't care about winning it. I desperately need to make it into the next round.
So I desperately
want to be in the New York in the finals.
You think all... Well, I don't even know if I should ask that.
What?
No, let's go on.
Come on.
Oh, what is this? Brain tonic.
Why? What was this question? It can't be that bad.
What do you, okay, it's not bad. I just don't know if I should say.
God, you gotta swallow it, man. It's the real world we're in. YOLO, baby.
I feel like I'm getting peer pressured by my friends.
You should.
You gotta steal the easy cheese. You got to.
If you're not acting like you want it and you're not acting cocky, like you're going to go up there and take it from those other motherfuckers. That's what. That's the way I look at it. Like, yeah, everybody's kind of like,
I like
I'm
the
just
nice guy that everybody roots for.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, I'm just honored to be in the competition and we're all just
well, someone's
got to
want to win.
Yeah,
someone's
got to
want to win.
No, nice knowing you guys. I'm glad that you think we're peers.
Yeah, I'm not.
I'm going to go get this now.
All right, I'm going to
That's what I'm saying. What Do you know what I'm saying? Like, that's who gets the shit.
I'm just honored to be a part of such
oh,
great
Oh, God, look at this fucking fag fest.
See, I didn't know we're allowed to say that in LA.
Fag fest, yeah.
Do you think, okay, so if we go to New York, what's your opinion? Because it's judged by fans, right? The final contest?
Yeah, New York's not going to be judged like there, but it's going to be full of industry.
But do you think all the comics on the New York will get something huge out of it, regardless of whether or not you win?
I think the comics that deserve it will.
Well, there's only two of them, so.
No, there's eight in New
Look,
York.
Look, oh, here's right. what's going to happen. I know I have the goods for a special, writing, a book, a pod, you know what I mean? I have like a package that I know I'm ready and I could sell.
Okay.
You've been doing it for a long time. You just filmed an hour special that's available on
iTunes.
Google, iTunes.
No, it's on iTunes,
Netflix,
Voodoo.
Hulu.
No, well, you let
United
me say
it. Eastbound flights.
Right after an Anthony Anderson failed pilot.
We got rented at Blockbuster.
Oh, yeah.
There's still those around?
Yeah. Why don't you fucking dig up your grandma, find the Blockbuster card she keeps on her. 300 Blockbusters still open in this country.
I can't
believe
That's
it?
300.
300?
Yep. I'm shocked it's that many.
I am too. Do you remember Errol's video?
No.
No.
Nobody remembers Errol's?
Where the fuck was that?
It was in Maryland. They all right,
nobody whatever. Lived in Maryland.
Errol's.
You know who lived in Maryland? People hiding from the law.
People afraid to go into D.C.
Yeah.
What did you ask me? Oh, my movie is available on Vudu, Cinema Now, Google Play, iTunes, and Amazon.
X Videos.
Great website.
RedTube.
It's Red called, Tube Spankwire.
It's called Eric Myers.
Jizzcam.com. What?
Jizzcam.com.
Jizzfest 2013.
Dopeless Romantic.
Yes, sir. It's actually 74 minutes. I'm nonstop.
Filmed in an alley.
filmed in a nice theater.
Filmed in an alley in Lakeland, Florida.
Want to remember where the Ninja Turtles lair was? You're going to love checking out where.
The set design was to look like a back alley.
We got a phone call from somebody. Hello.
Hello.
Hi. I can't hear them.
Hello?
I can barely hear.
I can't hear it. Can't hear
you're going to have to speak up or figure out your Skype. You got 3 seconds.
Sorry.
Oh, she's
You got to speak up.
Oh, no. Is it not working?
I'm still working.
Hi. What's her name? Hi. Gussie.
Stop staring at her picture like a creep. It's a still picture. It's not video.
What? I like that. Can I
Can we
it?
Hear her at all?
I can't.
I can hear. I mean, if we are quiet. We can hear.
You got to, like, yell.
Hi.
Hi.
Oh, God.
Sorry.
That's okay.
Okay, we got you now.
Everybody in the chat is having a go at me.
Oh, yeah. Well, I'd like to have a go
yeah,
at you.
Yeah, I was about to say the same thing. Can I come to where you're at?
That's a sexual joke.
I love that accent, man. Fuck.
You got the fish, I got the chips.
They're telling me to tell you that the thing's broken.
Oh, yeah, sweet.
What thing?
That thing.
We lost all our cameras.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, that one.
Well, that's just how it goes.
Maybe shit just got sexy and we don't want to broadcast it.
Yeah, maybe we just don't
Where
want
Where are the
video.
Cameras?
Well, let's not dwell on it. They're broken, clearly.
Turn them back on.
Okay, that's not helping either, just to yell at me.
I'm
repeated
sorry.
Things.
All right.
I'll kiss you.
Okay, well, they're broken.
Well, yeah.
Any
you
other
have
revelations?
A great day.
Can
no,
we have them fixed?
They told me to call in, so I was like, okay.
Do you just do everything the guys tell you to do?
No, I was going to, and then I was going to go to bed, and then they told me to.
Who
Where are you calling from?
England. Obviously England, yeah. It's nighttime.
Can I talk to her?
My bad.
You know, you're the third chair in this, and you're going to bark up and take over shit? Chris, I'll come down there. You're like the Dark Knight of the Kool-Aid. He looks like a Kool-Aid man, but he's wearing a black shirt.
I'm new, by the way.
Oh, God.
You're new to what?
No shit.
Podcast, so they're telling me to tell you that.
You know why?
I'm
because no girls stick around this show for very long. Doesn't happen.
Why not?
Oh, you'll find out. Is your name Gussie?
Yeah.
That's like your real name?
No.
No.
No, it's Kirsty.
Kirstie Alley.
I love it. What time is it in England? It's late, eh? You're going to go to bed?
8 hours. 11.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's 11.
Oh.
Somebody's international.
I am. I'm like James Bond.
Where do you live in England? You know, I was over there for a month this year. We could have made out.
I live in Sussex.
Oh, my God. Outside of London.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. You could have trained in. I was staying with a friend over near Westminster. We could have had some lovely escapades underneath the moonlight.
Well, that would have been lovely.
You have a boyfriend? How big is he? Could I take him on?
I don't know. He's pretty big.
I'll slit his goddamn throat. Do you know about Comedy Central being interested in me? Because I'm about to take off. I'm about to be a thing.
Yeah, I was listening to that.
You're in the semifinals.
Yeah, but they've seen it. They get it. You know what? They might actually not pass me to the next round just to fast track me on my own. They might pull me out of this competition because it's a conflict with how quickly they want
to
get me in.
They might
hour.
Get that fuck helicopter and just airlift you right to New York and do a special.
Oh, God.
So, Gussie, why'd you call up to this god-awful show?
I like it. It's nice.
I like your voice.
It's anything but nice, sweetie.
Well, I say nice. It's funny.
It's not funny. You know, I don't want to get this reputation.
It's funny that I'm here.
I don't want to get a reputation as a funny, nice guy.
I'm just going
to
be quiet.
No, you wouldn't
want
to do that as a comedian, would you?
Oh, God, now he's got a self-esteem issue down there.
Like,
why should I be able to talk? I'm
I want the cameras fixed.
I'm not going to do engineering right now, Eric. Can we let it go?
Can we pause?
No. We're never pausing.
What kind of ramshackle operation is this? I'm not even on cameras.
This is how bad...
I have cinema secrets.
This is
makeable.
How bad people are at podcast. You know, you said you're starting a podcast. Why wouldn't you? It's 2014. Perfect time to jump on that
bandwagon. It's 2013, Nostradamus.
By the time you guys get it up and running and anybody hears about it, it'll be 2014 if you're lucky.
Well, you're not coming on since you've insulted me.
Oh, yeah? I can't come on to your 11 listeners? I would slit my throat before I spent the money and gas to get on the other side of town to talk about horror movies with Gollum and his friend.
At least I didn't get it.
Well,
doesn't look like Gollum?
I'm just kidding. You motherfucker. I'll leave you here.
So, Gussie, what
poor
are you
piece
wearing?
Of shit.
Yeah, please.
I don't know what to say.
Everything.
Everything. You got like a fur coat on and shit. Is it cold in England?
You had an hour special that was like...
It was 74 minutes.
Who
was
shot
it?
Did you have
movie.
To pay for that? Did they come to you? Did
My
they?
Dad shot it on his iPhone.
Okay, come on now. It was a professional 3 or 4 camera outfit here.
I had it shot at Sears.
You had a crane cam.
What?
You had like a crane and stuff.
We had a crane...
There was a camera behind the fan.
We had a man on a jetpack flying around.
No, come on. It was a real production. Why are you being shy and coy about this?
I'm not.
You're a big star.
I'm telling my hilarious jokes.
You had 10 minutes of it's on YouTube for free.
Yeah, I don't know why they did that. They're like, we're going to put a teaser trailer.
It's 74 minutes. Why wouldn't you give 10 for free?
Because you know YouTube. You want to
hook them in. No, hook them in.
Hook them in?
Yeah, they should have done like 5 different 2-minute clips.
Yeah, they should have done a smaller thing, but whatever. Whatever. Asking? I'm sorry. What are you asking?
Yeah, like how did that come about?
Okay, well.
Because it seems like a cool process. You know, like if I was going to shoot a lot of comics do this. They hire a little production company. Mm-hmm. They shoot you can shoot a special.
Yeah.
And then try to shop it around to these places, Netflix and Google Play.
Yeah.
But sometimes somebody will come to you and go, hey.
That's what happened.
You want to buy some speakers off the back of this van? That's and you'll be like, no. And they'll be like, you want a comedy special? And you'll be like, yes, that I am interested in.
Well, now that you mention it.
Yeah.
This guy Chris Adcock.
Oh, we got a new caller. I'm sorry.
Shit.
He interrupted.
Do you want to hear my story?
No.
You asked for the story.
Well, we can't schedule callers. They call in when they call. Hi, call.
Hi.
Hey, what's up?
Who is this?
Who's this now?
Hey, this is Colin. I just wanted to say your show's great. We've got our server players listening to it. The last call in, Gussie, is a friend of ours.
Okay, man. You know, you guys are new to the phones.
Yeah, actually. It's weird because there's some serious lag. Like, I'm hearing you on the computer screen.
Oh, yeah?
And then, like...
Turn down the thing you're watching on and just talk on the phone.
Yep. Dude,
you know,
I'm trying to
you motherfuckers need to learn how to engage in the current conversation.
Don't yell at your
man,
fans.
Okay,
this
all right,
is all I do.
Don't yell at your
this
fans.
This is why I say no new fans on this show. We don't need them. It's too complicated.
I'm not a new fan. I'm a new caller, bro. I've been listening to your shit for like...
Oh, we've had enough of you.
You've been listening to this shit for years?
I just bang around.
I'm getting scared. He's got a taser.
No, I tell you this. You know, people are always like, Patrick, I told my friends about the show. I'm like, please don't. I'll get emails. How do I download it? What days are you on? When did I don't need new pressure. I'll take the ones we got. I think we're down to 14 downloads. I'm fine with it. It's cool. Go listen to Mark Maron and email him about your shit. I don't have time.
Well, listen to what the man has to say.
Up? Back to your issue.
Colin, what's up?
All right. Well, dude, just wanted to say keep on being...
Oh, great. Yeah, oh, I was about to quit. Good
like
thing you called in.
Thank you.
It's awesome.
Thank you so much.
Colin, you know Gussie?
Yeah. She's a friend of ours. She plays on our server. We told her to listen. We've got a bunch of people listening to your live stream now. It's pretty cool.
Oh, that's great. You're all playing what game? Fags a lot?
Minecraft.
What are you guys doing with your lives? Have you been outside?
You guys should get.
Yeah, it sucks.
You guys should probably go to.
God, how do you not all look like
me? Get a
me?
Whore. Get
I
a couple of whores to come
you're
over.
All fucking
play them.
Jumping around mining crafts. I don't know.
Get a bottle of whiskey, a bag of weed, and a prostitute. You guys
hey,
have some
well,
like me.
You know,
who wrote that?
Fun.
Lego Hitler?
You know, it's a
Minecraft.
Great way to communicate with people, meet new people. I mean, we got people from all over the
you
world.
You can meet
like,
new people out
Idaho.
At the store, Borks.
You ever been to a bar?
Get out in the world.
Like, we're fucking Idaho.
You're in Idaho?
You're fucking meeting a girl who will never suck your dick.
Do you have any fans in the city?
No.
Idaho, Sussex. We're going to call.
Oh,
Bella.
Yeah.
We're
I'm sorry.
Mine in
I'm sorry. We got two calls out of the world, and they weren't within a 30-mile radius for you to go visit. What is your neediness?
My neediness?
Why do they have to be local? I'd prefer they're not.
What?
I don't like anybody nearby enough to kill me.
I don't know. Californians, I'm not sure they really get what you're doing, man.
Oh, God.
I don't know if they can get this highbrow material. Do they, you think they get?
We've been talking about our dicks for a little bit.
Ranting.
What are you trying to do exactly that
just
people don't get?
Just get this guy off the phone.
I didn't put him on. I was in the middle of my goddamn story.
I know.
You put him on to
he
say
called,
he knows
he
the
called up to go. He called up to go keep on doing what you're... No shit, dog.
Whoa, man. Just some support here.
You're such an asshole, Pat.
Oh, man. I am done.
Colin.
I am having my internet burned to
you
the ground when this
pot.
Is over.
You were a nicer guy when we smoked.
All right. Well, you do that. You do that. And I'm going to hop off here, but I'm going to keep listening to your shit.
No! Turn it off! Get out!
No.
Turn
you.
Off the mines! Turn off the craft! Turn it all down!
Oh, jeez.
Go outside! You know, there's a reason you're in your parents'... Okay, he's gone. What happened with the story? I'd love to hear about the...
Are we going to have another call from someone?
God hopes that we don't get any more fan interaction on this program. I hate it.
What are the point of these calls? People are like, I like your show.
They're
you're like, fuck
worst.
You! You
it's a girl
sucker.
Who's not allowed to be up past 11:30.
Why did she call if she had to go to bed?
Yeah, hey, I'm just calling to let you know I'm done with you guys. Cool, bitch.
All right, so about 2 years ago, this guy Chris...
It was a night just like tonight.
Do you want me to tell the story?
Yeah.
Do you want me to tell the story?
I'd love it.
Do you want me to tell the stories?
I'd love it.
All right. 2 years ago...
On the Christian calendar. I mean, what are we going by?
We're going by the time we use in the world. 2 years ago, some guy Facebooked me.
Oh, world time. One of my favorites.
You've got a funny one-liner for everything. Am I going to be able to get through this fucking story?
Probs not.
2 years ago, you shut the fuck up for 1 minute. Just let me tell the story and I'll be done. Please, please,
yeah.
Please. I'm going to shove this brain tonic up your fucking fat ass.
Promises.
All right, 2 years ago, this guy... Where's the taser? Don't he fucking... Okay, 2 years ago... Don't say anything. Patrick? At least look interested. Can you pretend to be interested in the story? You look so uninterested. Your eyes lie.
No, I'm really interested. I asked the question.
How many years ago?
More than one, but less than four.
Good enough. Some guy Facebooked me, and he said he had a budget. He saw me over from Michael Winslow in Tampa, and he wanted to make a movie. So that's what we did. And then we got a distributor, and we sold it.
But you, and not a movie, just a
It's a full-length feature movie. It's a full-length feature, 75 minutes.
But it's stand-up.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, you can't just, because it's 70 minutes, you can't go, it's a feature.
Why? I'm trying to get laid.
It's just a comedy special.
It is not just a comedy special. It's more than that.
What do you mean it's not just a comedy special?
It's my soul bared for humanity.
Now, do you have a new hour?
What? I barely had that fucking
You're
hour.
Still doing that shit?
Well, yeah.
Oh, God.
I wrote
heard
two,
it.
I have a new joke.
Well, when you release a special and like maybe 75 people have seen it, you can't really throw the material away.
Why would you fucking say that to him? You know, we're trying to pep him up for a contest.
He's confident.
How's your special? Oh, you special. Don't have one.
God, we don't want his.
Neither do you. You don't know. You don't
Put
know
him that. On. Take that microphone
I don't
away.
Get it. Why you would hang out with this dork.
I need a ride.
That's what it is.
It was him or the lift.
Oh, God. If you show up in my yard with one of those pink mustaches, I'd go out on my porch with a shotgun.
How embarrassing is it to be in that fucking thing with that pink mustache?
Oh, only if the guy's cute.
What?
Nothing.
Huh?
Well, that's cool. So how long did it take?
To film it?
To shoot it, yeah. To find a place, to find where did you shoot? Where did you...
We filmed it at the... Did you ever do Winter Circle in Lakeland?
Oh, I thought it was a homeless cafe.
I have never been so insulted.
Okay.
You brought me on here to make a fool of me.
No.
I'm a professional entertainer. I will not be made a mockery of. I will not be made a mockery of. I make people happy. Is that a crime? Then lock me away, Patrick.
No, okay. So you found out where the Ninja Turtles' lair was. You made sure Vanilla Ice wasn't living there.
It does not look like the Ninja Turtles' lair.
Go Ninja, go Ninja, go, go Ninja.
I love how the Ninja Turtles bust in the club and he comes up with that song in like 3 seconds. Mutant Adam creatures busted. He's like, go Ninja, go Ninja, go.
Yeah. All right. He's great. Robert Van Winkle is great at cranking out the hits.
Look, it took a couple months to get everything.
Yeah.
Yes.
You shot at the Winter Circle in Lakeland?
No, the Polk Theater.
Oh, okay.
It was near Winter Circle. I was just saying, because you know Winter Circle. You played at Winter Circle.
I've never played at the Winter Circle.
You haven't played at Winter Circle?
No.
Chris, you have.
I do clubs when I go to Florida.
Oh, my. Aren't we fancy? Mr. Nope. Comedy Central's.
Nope. Well, actually, yeah. Have you heard about Comedy Central being interested in me?
Are you sure that's not a misprint? Are you sure it was somebody else they picked?
I thought you won in Hollywood. You won in Irvine. Okay. Which, I like that club better.
Yeah.
But I thought you won in Hollywood, which was crazy.
No, Hollywood was too many people, so they put me in Irvine.
How many nights did... Everybody only did one night 10 people, right?
I think Hollywood did two, but don't quote... I'm not exactly
sure. How did you like get selected to go to Irvine? Or did you have to audition for that spot?
No, my managers contacted Jamie. I contacted Jamie, my managers contacted Jamie, and bam.
You made it happen.
I made it happen. I make shit happen. That's what I do.
Then you went and you rocked it.
Yes.
And now you have to, next Wednesday night, travel to San Francisco with your sidekick.
Chris.
I'm not going.
What?
Motherfucker. You're driving him up. Well, so you guys are crashing in a hotel together.
Yes.
God. I'm coming up. Can I stay in your hotel too?
You got to sleep in Eric's bed.
Can we wheel in a cot?
Do you need a place to stay?
Can we wheel in a cot and just have a slumber party?
It's his room. It's his room. I mean, I'm down.
I can figure something out.
Yeah,
I
you can stay if you want.
You got that cheddar on Priceline.
We don't need three. Yeah, we don't need
the three of us in one bed?
We're only going to be there for a night.
We can make some new headshots.
Let's have some bottom shots. I'm good.
Good show.
Dude,
good show as usual. No, fucking, you have to perform in San Francisco.
I woke up for this. What?
Against the who's who list. You have the big, tough lineup over there.
I'm scared.
And only 2 out of 10. You know, I thought it was going to be like 8 people, and they were going to take 2 out of 8.
Do you think I'm going to win?
Ooh, that's tough.
Do you think I'm the best comic you've ever seen ever?
No. I could, you know, I could sleep and probably beat you. Pretty funny. And people love fat people because it's real. Have you seen Mike and Molly?
It's real sad.
I'm like, yeah. Yeah, it is.
No, wait, Patrick.
No, here's the thing. Look,
will you let me ask you something?
No, because I'm answering your other question first.
What was the other question? I forgot.
Do I think you're the funniest ever in the world?
Do you think I'm the best comedian that has ever lived? Be honest.
No. But I don't know how to answer that question objectively, and that's my point with who's going to win. You're going to be up against some jumping around black guy. You're going to be up against an Asian. You're going to be up against a couple girls. You're going to be up against, you know, some Indian dude who's got dots and jokes about his parents.
Oh, my God.
And how do you judge you against that? You know, it just depends on what they're looking for that day.
You're absolutely right.
There's no way to judge, like, an Indian comic who talks about his culture and family against what you do. Like, how do you, if he's super funny and you're super funny, how do you go, well one's better? Like,
no, that's
they're
a
two
point.
Totally
it's
different.
I want to win.
You just got to go up and do your best.
It's like going, what's better, chocolate ice cream or
strawberry
you
ice
know,
cream?
Banana ice cream with nipple shavings?
Chocolate. So, but for, I can't think of what I was going to say.
But I've got Fort Lauderdale. These are easy. I can beat all the people in
Florida.
My old
roommate's going up against you.
Dan Dakotas. He's like a baby-faced young kid with long hair. I got this.
Dan is a killer.
Come on.
Dan is a killer.
He looks like a killer.
He looks like a serial killer.
Yeah. He looks like he's placed a Craigslist ad or two.
If do you want to do a thing? If you win, do you want to give me half the money and put me on your show?
I'm sorry. What?
If you win, if I win, I'll give you half the money and I'll put you on my show. If you win, you give
What's
me half
your show?
Comedy Central will develop a show about me. Then we have double chance to win. We can't do this alone, Patrick.
I don't know about the money, but the show, you know, I would just pick funny people to be in my show who are friends, you know.
No, I get half. You give me half your money, you put me on your show as the second lead, and I'll do the same for you. Why?
First of all, I don't believe in you.
What?
Second of all, you're on a dangerous path, man.
A dangerous path?
Yeah.
What do you mean?
This is probably like your last big shot at the game. And what if you just said this shit to people? No, it really doesn't. It feel that way sometimes. It's like
I feel like I'm a bad movie.
No, you really need. It's like yeah, I really
I feel like the baseball movie with the old guy. Like this is my last shot. You know, like
no, but I do feel that. Yeah, it's like I really need this W. Yeah, really need this W.
What do you? If you win, are you gonna be like fucking crazy? How do you think your life will change?
All I want to win is this next round. Yeah. I don't give. I honestly do not give a fuck after that. Like, I will still try to win the overall.
You don't want all that prize?
Yeah, but I'll get all that. I'll get all that shit.
You think so?
Yeah, I'll get a Comedy Central show, and I'll get a fucking radio show and all that. I have 10 years of radio. I'm not worried about getting what I deserve once people look at me.
Okay.
So I just need people to look at me. And getting in that 8-person showcase will get a lot of people to look at you.
I'm very excited.
You know what I mean?
Yes.
That's a career.
Yes.
Now, what they're giving you, a Comedy Central record deal, comedy show on Comedy Central, you know, whatever that is. They'll probably be like John Oliver in New York or something.
What do you tape the record at? How does that work?
One of your clubs. They're going to give you work in all the clubs.
I want to win.
Like those 26 Comedy Central certified clubs you'll headline, mm-hmm. if you can. Here's the problem, and this is what's going to happen. A lot of people are going to win these semifinals. Like, I know of people who have been doing comedy 3 years or less who are in the semifinals.
Really?
Which shouldn't happen. Like, technically shouldn't fucking happen. But the problem is...
But you can't tell when you see somebody do 7.
Right.
How long
it's easy to rock out a 7, which is like... I was kind of disappointed when I found out we had to do 7 again. Because I was like, you know, if you gave us 15, which I know it's tough to do 10 people 15. So that wasn't going to happen. But if you did give us 15, it would weed out some of the shit real quick. Because not everybody has a killer 15.
And doing a longer set.
The longer the set goes.
A 45-minute set is a different animal.
If you did a 45-minute set, people would crumble. How many of the 40 do you think could do a 45-minute set, a show?
I only know 3 people.
Maybe 10.
I would say even 7.
I couldn't say.
Maybe 10.
Judging by that list, I'd say maybe 7. 7 guys.
But don't you think they would step up if they had to?
But I've headlined a show and done an hour in the past month.
Okay, but you know what?
You've headlined a show and done an hour in the past month. You have an hour on tape.
Yeah.
Like, I'm saying we could do that. So that the crowd, the longer the set, the more differentiated those people are going to become.
But
when it's 7 minutes, it's anybody's game. So what's going to happen is somebody with not enough experience and not enough exposure and not enough goods behind it will go to that showcase, perform that showcase, and fall into obscurity after they get written about because they don't have the goods to back it up. They can't even feature.
Right.
They don't have 25 or 30.
Me and Chris were talking about that in the car, like, because some people are names or they're famous.
Yeah.
They start doing stand-up, and they only have 10 minutes.
And they don't even work to... I think they're
charging for tickets.
There are examples of people who... You know, Charlie Murphy was one of those guys who just was on Chappelle's show and... was like, I'll do stand-up, and had maybe 15 minutes ready to go when he started booking headlining dates. And he's developed it.
Didn't he bring, like, Donnell with him, though? He brought a couple of guys.
He brought a couple of people. Yeah, but what happened was when he got 45 minutes, he was doing an hour and a half. And it's like, dude, if you just did the 45, it's tight and good. Because he wasn't bad. I worked with him 3 or 4 times. He wasn't bad. He would just stretch it, and it would just be like, dude.
Why did he?
Yeah, I mean, you got a good 40. Mm-hmm. Just do the 40, 45. And, it's just a problem.
Yeah, that happens a lot.
So now there's going to be 7 minutes. It's going to be easy for somebody with 3 years of experience to kill in 7 minutes and move on. And at that showcase, you're probably going to get 10 or 15. And
how long do you think the 8-minute, New York will be? 10 to 15?
10 to 15, yeah, probably.
But do you think Comedy Central is going to, like, check on people's backstories and see who can do what? Put them accordingly?
I don't think so.
No?
If they're doing that, they're doing it now, I would think.
Well, and if they're doing that, then they're going to see who's not experienced, and then it's not really a contest. It's just
yeah. But can you from online? Do you think you can go look at everybody, see how long they've been in the game, how experienced they are?
You
what
could
doing?
If you watch
you
their
take
most...
their name, you could Google them, you could call yeah. clubs and be like, have you ever heard of this guy? What is he doing?
Not even that. You could watch their clip. I mean, you can see a guy on a 10-minute clip, and you can kind of see where they're at. You
I don't know if that's true.
I wonder if they're doing that for all four. I would think they're doing that for. Do you think they're researching the people they're going to be? I have to imagine it's the same judges are going to be in every city.
I don't know.
Since
don't
they're
know
flying, they're
that.
Flying Jonah Ray around to host them all.
Yeah.
So I have to imagine who'd your email you got from Ann and Miro. I got an email.
No, I didn't get that. My email was from a guy. But he said, talk to Ann and Miro when you get to San Francisco.
Okay. And so I was told, so they're going to be in Fort Lauderdale, too.
Yeah, it was Ann, Miro,
so
and
I think
one other guy.
They're going to be the judges, these Comedy Central people,
okay.
across all four, which makes me feel better, too.
Yeah. And even if you don't win, they can still see you and be like, this guy would be great on this show or for this thing.
Yeah,
you know
the
I mean?
Truth is you're down to 40, and they've looked at you.
Yeah. Do you think they looked at every single tape, even the people that didn't make the prelims? I guess they did if they got it. Or
yeah, because they went through them and found people they wanted.
Yeah, because Tone had an awesome set.
270 tapes to look at. So I imagine they did that in a week.
Because mine was tight. I mean, I was surprised I won because, like, Nick Guerra killed. I mean, Tone Bell killed. I mean, Kayvon killed. So it was like, it wasn't one of those shows where you're like, I definitely got this.
Well, they apparently told the club people, you know, what they were looking for, certain types.
How do you know that?
I saw, like, some of the documentation that was sent out to club managers and stuff.
Were you supposed to see that?
I mean, I don't think it was, like, secret.
What were they looking for?
It was just, like, defined type, like, people who you could see. Like, I don't remember the exact thing. There was, like, a slideshow presentation that got mailed to these clubs.
So, like, the hipster white guy.
Yeah, I think they gave them more than that. Like, you know, but.
Something marketable.
Yeah.
I mean, it's show business. It makes sense.
I looked last year. They didn't have any fat guys last year. So, it's the year of the fat guy.
Well, you're a shoo-it.
But I'm the last. Mine's the last semifinal, so it'll be interesting to see. I guess they're going to announce the winners the night of, right?
Well, what's the space?
It's going to be like perform.
What's the space and time between like yours and yours?
His is the 26th. Mine's the 16th. Yours is the
26th, 23rd.
Right? So before the end of the month, they're going to have all these taken care of.
The 23rd's the last one.
Okay.
Chicago's tomorrow.
And then November 6th is New York. So
wait, Chicago's tomorrow. Yours is the 23rd.
Wow, so they, it's going to take them.
When's Boston? The 21st. Or something around there.
21st.
It's gonna take
and then
about,
mine's the 23rd.
About 2 weeks to find out. Well, not even that, because you figured they're going to
I think they're going to announce them on stage that night.
Yeah.
No shit.
Yeah. I think they know who they want.
Are you going to cuss? It said a little bit of cussing's okay.
I'm not.
Not at all? Do you cuss in your normal act? I haven't seen
yeah.
it.
Yeah.
Like gratuitously or no, just whatever?
I talk how I talk.
But it's not like you can take the cussing out of what
it is. Yeah, I just, okay. I was actually watching my tape. And seeing how I surgically removed lines that would back me into a corner having to cuss, and I was doing it so fluidly that I couldn't believe how smooth it was. I was like, oh, I just didn't say that line. I just didn't say that. And I was editing. It was almost like the perfect state of mind for being on your, you know, because we don't want to be on that autopilot level for a competition.
Yeah.
Because I really tried to be more animated and bigger and play it bigger and spark it up on stage.
Of course.
Because you have to.
Yeah.
But. Yeah, I also think editing kind of on the fly a little bit, you're where you would normally curse.
Oh, yeah.
Because I do a WT fuck in the middle of one of those jokes because I'm setting it all up for these shirts. I say, like, WT fuck a lot.
Right.
Because it's, which, you know, it's still what the fuck, but you're not, you know.
Now, for you, like, how... Did you know exactly what set you were going to do going in there? Like, how much thought was taken into what set I'm
going to do? I didn't put it together until I got to the club.
Seriously?
Yeah.
Because I knew mine. I went over it with Chris, like, the day before.
I had one bit that I wanted to do. It's this bit called Aquarius. We're talking about this guy named Aquarius who worked at the Tampa Crown Plaza, who I called down, and he's, like, a southern black guy.
Yeah.
And the reason I want to do that joke is because it shows character. Like, so I'm doing his voice, like, hello, this is Aquarius. I do, like, a voice of him, so it shows a character, and I also do, like, I talk about, like, it just shows a couple things, like, creativity, character. Like, so I was trying to, like, but you also kind of want to do, like, a developmental set. You got to talk about you.
Right.
You got to, like,
so I did the
tell who
stuff.
You are.
I did the
so
rehab stuff straight up.
I do some, like, self-deprecating shit up front. You got to dress that you're fat. because you're fat.
Yeah.
But I try to get out of that. So I have like three phases. I'm doing like a couple self-deprecating things up front.
Okay.
Talking about like a like some gym shit and stuff. Then I go straight into this Aquarius bit. And another bit that's like just some absurdities.
Right.
Like that I have observational stuff. Then it goes right into relationship like shit, like dealing with women. And I end on that.
So
because it's the strongest. And that kind of follows how I do my act.
Mm.
Like it's just really like a microcosm of my act.
That's my act. I start with self-deprecating. And
yeah,
I end with women. Sex. Yeah. The dirtiest stuff.
Yeah.
And the rest
but by the time you get to that, it's destroying. Like not they, you know. They know who you are, so now when
you
I'm telling...
You gotta work up to the dirties.
Well, yeah. Now that you know who I am and how I look at the world, this right. is the way it's set up, so now you know who I am mm-hmm. and how I look at the world.
Sure.
Now when I'm calling women not people and, you know, less than dogs and all this shit, like, it doesn't come across... You know, I don't say less than dogs.
As abrasive.
But I'm saying, yeah,
abrasive.
You've built up a point of view by that point,
right.
So it's like, okay, well, you can see how he thinks that.
But you said you did 2 minutes that you didn't like. What was the reason behind that?
Not that I didn't like, I was just watching it last night. One of them is, when I hosted at the Tampa Improv for like 8 years, I was always opening with this easy drinking joke.
Yeah.
But it's like a gay joke. And it's just a good, like, funny crowd test kind of joke.
It's just a good boom.
It's a quick misdirection edgy. So you like, if you didn't laugh at that, I know I'll keep it a little cleaner.
Gotcha.
And it just, I was looking at the time. I was watching the time. I don't know if you got your set from the club. We should email the club and like watch your set and time, you know, get your time.
They sent you a link to it?
Yeah.
I know it is 6 minutes, 30 seconds.
See, what I'm doing is I looked at that
They'll
joke.
Do it for free? They'll send you the link?
Yeah, I was just like, I'm representing your club and I want to make my set tight as possible. And can I have a look at my set?
Oh, so
and they were like, just don't put it up, you know?
So for home club, I should put Irvine Improv. Because I just figured since I lived in Hollywood, I just put the Hollywood because I didn't really
they
know.
They put home club? Is that what they asked? Home club?
Just say you can mention your home club, which I just moved here 9 months ago, but I since I live in Hollywood, I put the Hollywood Improv.
Yeah.
But I did it in Irvine, so I didn't know if I should put Irvine Improv, but I don't...
Well, I mean, you're being sent as a representative of the Irvine Improv.
I see. Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
I mean, you were the winner from that club.
Right. But I was confused as the one.
Yeah.
Because I live like an hour away. So, but that's fine. I mean, I love Irvine Improv. It was a great place. It was a great show.
So anyway, what was I saying? I forget.
You were saying that test.
Yeah. So I wanted to, it was taking up like 50 seconds and it's one punchline at the end. And I was just like, I'd rather tell another story, take that out, take another bit that was kind of disjointed out and tell another longer bit. That's mm-hmm. a story there. Mm-hmm. That's about dating.
I see.
On the end that has more jokes and more of a punch and more of a point of view.
Gotcha.
I don't know. To be honest, I don't know.
Well, you can't overthink it. You'll drive yourself crazy.
Yeah, I mean,
I'm trying not to overthink it.
The best thing is, like, you're not doing anything new, so it's not like you have to memorize anything. It's not pressure.
Right. It's like you said, you can't rewrite. Because even now, I'm like,
well, you won't be yourself. You'll be unnatural.
You got to be yourself. That's the biggest thing. And you got to be professional, you know?
Oh, God. I don't know anything.
You've been doing this for 10 years. Wow.
Oh, God.
Why did podcasts? I don't know anything about podcasts. Why did they wane in popularity? Was there a reason?
Well, they're not. It's not that they wane in popularity. It's just there's hundreds of thousands
over
of them
saturation.
Now. Yeah, it's like honestly, dude. If you start a podcast today, like to get to 500 listeners ever, you'd be doing very well. Like it's
really?
Just, yeah, it's just there's so much shit.
So not even if you had like a name on to drive people in,
dude. I've had everybody from. You know, Bob Saget to Jim Norton in here.
Yeah.
Which is fine, but it's not going to spike. You know, over a long term, like when you look back over the year and you look at all your shows, you'll see one got downloaded way more than others because it has a keyword of Doug Benson or whatever the fuck
right,
there. But it's not like those people are going to come back next week to see what you are like without Doug Benson. You know what I mean? Like,
that's
a Doug Benson fan who came to check out Doug Benson on the show.
But it's got to rope a few people in, no? Like they just like you and your style, and they would have never heard
it's
you.
It's like people who go see a movie with Mark Wahlberg because Mark Wahlberg's in it, not because they like M. Night Shyamalan movies. And the next M. Night Shyamalan movie, they might not have anybody in it they like. They're not going to go see it because it's an M. Night Shyamalan movie. They only like the one with Mark Wahlberg in it.
But I'm saying a couple might like it. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah, of course. Of course. More exposure absolutely is not bad.
Right.
But I just, I don't know. Today I'm trying to figure out like what's the most bang for your buck as far as the time you would have to invest and the time you would have to. And I got to think it's like YouTube now.
Yeah, but that, Jesus. I mean, there's so much shit on YouTube.
Yeah, but you got to have a gimmick. You can't just, you know, the problem is there's so much shit on. People go, well, there's so much on YouTube now. Yeah, but it's just a fat kid eating in front of the camera. Like, that's not a show.
Yeah, but that's got 7 zillion hits. Fat guy falls down steps.
Yeah, no, but if you produced a show that had
like a web series
value, yeah, that was weekly and consistent and
I might do
funny.
That.
I've been looking to do something like that out of here, you know? Like, if you have an idea and it's good.
I do.
And funny.
I do have an idea.
Yeah. Well, I'll help you produce it if you're interested.
Do you want to?
Yeah, let's talk.
It's about horror
movies. I'm looking for people who want to do shit.
I've got
no one
an
wants
idea.
To do shit.
I've got two websites.
Yeah, we all have ideas.
No,
and then I
good.
Jerk off and fall asleep.
No, I do shit.
Chris. I want to film shit.
I'm up every morning at fucking like 8 a.m.
Wait,
doing
do you have
shit.
A special or a feature?
What?
Do you have a feature out? I thought I saw a feature. Listed. You've done a feature, right?
A feature
I'm
film?
Fucking, I'm just fucking with you about your special.
In
Is that a feature?
Face, it's a full-length feature.
Hey, guys,
film.
You want to watch Eric's special? It's a feature!
Look, I have two episode ideas. Let's talk. Let's talk.
I have two. You want to hear mine?
Sure.
Here's one. You remember Peeps? The little candies?
Yes.
Now imagine...
But they're gigantic?
Nope.
And had sex with people?
What? No, come on. You know, I'm trying to put together a real show. Imagine if Peeps never existed.
My mind just got blown.
And what would I eat on Easter?
Cadbury eggs. Like
oh,
American.
Don't even start.
What?
I want to do a cooking show where we replace all the ingredients with, like, instead of eggs, you have Cadbury eggs, and you have to, like, make pancakes with Cadbury eggs. No eggs. Or they'll have like
the worst slash best idea.
What do you mean?
Can you think Vegemite? Is it Vegemite
cracking?
Delicious?
No, you won't think Vegemite's delicious and Marmite. This is yeast.
Why do people eat Vegemite sandwiches? Is it that
gross? They spread it on toast because they just sometimes they're like, I don't deserve good tasting food.
How bad is it?
It's like it's bitter yeast. It's like the most unedible. Like I won't even open it.
How can people eat it in like Australia?
But that smells horrible.
Oh, because they like. It's first like, of all, have you seen those kids covered in flies and what they eat? You eat whatever you got. Like if you bottle shit, you remember what?
Is it good for you? Is
Tommy Boy said, "I could shit in a box and market guaranteed.
Right,
somebody will buy it." Ugh. Like that's what they're doing over there. They think this is real food.
What's Marmite?
I think they're eating based off of dare. I think they don't even like it. They're just trying to look badass in front of other
concentrated
people.
Yeast extract.
That's
it's like yeast shit.
Ugh. He just smiled and made me a Vegemite sandwich.
Oh, God.
I want to tell you my website episodes.
Okay.
Can I do it on the air or off the air?
Yeah, let's do it. First idea and go.
No, because you're going to make fun of it and discount it.
Discount it?
Discount it.
First idea, Eric Myers webisode. Go.
Okay. We are.
Take one.
It's a buddy cop show.
Oh, God.
Okay? You're the loose cannon. And I... No, I'm kidding. No, I gotta. I'll tell you off the air. All right, Elton. I guess that's why they call it the blues, huh, Chris? That is the show. I don't even need words. Just you wearing those glasses, walking around Burbank.
I can't see now.
What?
I think we have a call. It's Moody from New Zealand who sent me the Marmite.
Is Marmite good?
No, it's terrible. I hate it.
Why do people eat it?
I don't know what it is. I've just called in to explain what it is.
Oh.
It's basically what's left over after you brew beer.
I have no glasses on.
So it's the, like, processed beer sludge.
Is that what it is?
You can see, like, this far in front of my face.
Marmite and Vegemite is the same thing? Or what's the
grab
difference?
Grab that taser.
More or less. Vegemite's more Australian, and Marmite is, like, New Zealand and the UK.
And that, but it's the same kind of thing. And you put it on toast? Is it inedible? Like, is it disgusting? And even...
Yeah, you're meant to use only a little bit, but I think that's because it tastes like
yeah,
shit.
Yeah, yeah. I love those things. Like, oh, you shouldn't use that much lemon juice. Oh, why? Because it's horrible and ruins everything?
Well, why do people eat it at all?
No one says easy on the Nutella, but... I mean,
yeah. No one's ever put too much Nutella on their toast. Ah, this is far too chocolatey and delicious.
Why do people eat it at all?
I don't know.
That's why they put it in a jar that's shaped like Nutella, so you buy it by mistake.
Well, once you smell it, you can't be like, this is disgusting.
Well. and the Marmite's a bit more bitter than the Vegemite, so Vegemite might be better to start off with if you're looking to
If you want to start off eating shitty foods, Marmite's the good.
This is alcohol free, right?
Yeah, man.
But
I wouldn't do that to you.
It's everywhere, though. Like, any house you go to, there'll be Marmite and Vegemite there.
Why?
I don't know. I have no idea. It's something that I've never gotten used to.
But no one really eats it. They just have it.
No, they eat it. Some people will say, I really like Marmite.
Do your parents eat it?
No.
Does your sister?
No.
So do you just put it on toast, or what? Do you, like, put it in something and dull down the flavor?
You spread it on toast, but you spread it so thin that you can still see the toast underneath it.
And it just has a strong pungent. Let me smell this. Let me smell it. Patrick, let me smell it.
Oh, somebody's got a great idea for a show. I'm not opening it. It's not open.
Let's put it on toast and eat it a little bit.
Oh, let's not.
Why?
Because I'm having a nice day.
Just put a little bit on some toast and we'll eat it. Can we do that? Come on.
I don't even have bread.
Put a little bit on crackers.
Oh, yeah, I'm the guy who doesn't have bread, yet I have many crackers to choose from.
You live in a nice house. You don't have bread in this house?
I don't have bread.
How old are you? You don't have bread in your
I don't eat bread. I'm trying not to be carb-alicious.
You don't eat bread?
No, I eat wraps.
Do you have
fucking
fajita?
You should listen to what Carson from Queer Eye is telling you.
Somebody's got a great idea for a show.
What am I? Who from Queer Eye?
You
want to
hear
a
webisode idea?
Wait, he just called me Carson from Queer Eye. What?
You want to hear? You're real fired up, man. Do you want to hear a webisode idea?
Yeah, go ahead.
It's about a ghost who is an attorney. And it's called Possession is 9/10 of the Law.
Oh, God, help us.
Wonk, wonk.
That's pretty good. God, you're fucking wrecked, man. You want to be, for a living, you want to handle microphones.
Huh?
For a living, you want to handle microphones.
Well, they don't have this big block of shit.
Yeah, they do. Everywhere you go, man. You ever been on the radio?
Yes.
God.
Yes, I've been on the radio several times.
So, like, did you guys have to film during non-flooding hours in that sewer?
Can we have some Vegemite?
No, I'm not opening
you
it.
You are a pussy.
You're out of your mind for wanting to fucking eat that.
I'm just not going to open it right now and crack the seal.
Pussy!
It's going to smell like a fucking prostitute's cunt in here. It's going to smell horrible.
Christopher.
Do you really, your idea of a pussy is a person who won't eat from a FDA sealed like thing that you're allowed to eat?
There's a reason why they don't sell this in the United States.
Well, he's only read about
they sell in the United States.
How can you not even try it?
Are you gonna rock my glasses now? Because they are pretty
bald.
I'd rather eat a koala's pussy.
I've tried it. Just because I haven't cracked this jar doesn't mean I haven't had it.
Genie,
now you look like Carson.
Daniel,
my brother.
I do look good in these.
I've tried it. It's gross.
I look good in these.
Are you listening to me?
No.
You have like 9 different conversations going on.
I look good in these, don't I, Chris?
Look at the camera. Good. The camera's over here.
Huh?
Your camera's
I'm looking
here.
At myself.
Yeah, but look at the camera here.
Oh, I waved to myself.
The camera's here now.
Do I look good?
No. Is that a chip clip you picked up off my counter? What's happening?
I'm fidgety. I'm fidgety with shit.
Don't use the N-word.
Fidgety.
Sorry. Sorry.
What about for me, though?
Do you know what I got? I flew back from Florida to L.A. via Charlotte and Chicago, because that's an efficient route.
You had 2 layovers?
You went where?
Florida, Tampa, Charlotte, Chicago, L.A. That's a good route.
Well, I flew
United.
Back. I flew from Orlando to Charlotte to L.A. You had to go through Chicago too.
Yeah, that's what I just said, man. That's why I'm pissed.
Fuck.
Not a good route.
How much money did you save by taking 2 layovers versus 1?
None.
Like nothing. Did you spend more money at the airport?
Then they lost my luggage.
Fuck, bro.
The next morning they did bring it to me. However, it was busted open.
Oh, is that why you're wearing that shirt?
No. This is just one of the 3 that'll cover me.
Oh, okay.
It was busted open, and inside they had placed a black woman's earrings. And the reason I know they were black women's is because either that or this is the Ringling Brothers and Barnum and Bailey goddamn 3 rings. I mean, a whole set of like 7 different sets of earrings, like hoops, giant hoops.
Yeah.
They thought that belonged in my suitcase. I also had a child's sock.
When in Rome.
They picked up one of your shirts and like, this is obviously a woman's dress, so let's make sure we get the earrings. 3rd chair coming back.
This is a fancy Guinness Stout evening gown to be worn by Patricia Melton. Do you want to hear my web series or not?
I'm gonna go then. If he's gonna keep talking, yeah, all right. See ya.
Were you still there?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's fine. I don't really want.
Moody, you know, I apologize for today. We'll have a better show tomorrow.
It's all right.
We'll get some real people in here. This is real rough.
Well, it's nice that Danny Tamborelli's trying to kickstart his career again.
Who?
Don't worry. I'm just gonna go.
Who was that? Yeah. No, come on, stand by your failed joke.
I just called him Danny Tamborelli, not him, the guy at the back. I don't know his name.
Chris.
Oh, me.
Yeah.
Oh no.
Is Danny just some fat guy?
Oh no. Oh no.
And who am I? The queer eye for the straight guy.
Hold on, where'd you say Marmite was from, Moody?
It's
I don't care.
I didn't even know he was still alive.
Wait, what's the name of the guy again I look like? Because I want to see if I look like him.
Danny Tamborelli.
I don't care.
Danny Tamborelli. My hairline looks awful.
Why are you just staring at yourself in the monitor? You face the camera. You're doing a show. Look at the camera.
Huh? Do you want to hear my web series?
Oh, I got to turn this off.
Do you want to hear my web series?
No, you can't look at yourself. Pitch it here.
All right. It's
2.5 men. They already have it.
You play a down on his luck seamstress.
2 men and a baby?
What? You're a down on his luck seamstress.
Oh, yeah, that's
and
me.
And I am a scarecrow that can only become to life when you wear magical glasses.
When I sew you things to wear.
You sew me a new outfit and give me a job at a law firm. It's called Scarecrow and...
Scarecrow and the Misses.
Yes.
Give me one of your ideas for real.
All right.
Do you not like that? Is it fizzy?
No, I do like it. Okay, it's called The Midnight Show, right? And it's like The Tonight Show with Johnny Carson. Only
next.
I'm a huge horror movie fan, so we're going to review horror movies, horror culture, the latest shows like Walking Dead, Dracula, the latest movies that are out.
I've never gotten into The Walking Dead. Worth it?
Yeah, it's awesome. We'll have 2 guests and like a cool, and then we'll just talk about the latest horror stuff. It'll be a half an hour kind of campy show. And I want to do it as a web series. And horror is huge now, and we'll make it funny.
And everybody will have blood capsules and that they bite down on at the end, and it just runs down your face. That's how you sign off.
You can do whatever the fuck you want. I'll come on to a monologue. We'll have a sketch, right? We'll do it like that.
Can we call it?
The Midnight Show is the cool name.
I want to call it. Oh, the horror.
Oh, the horror? Are you an assassin?
Let's call it the 1205 show. Let's make it fashionably.
I actually like Oh the Horror. That's actually a good title.
Let's make it.
Do you want to help me produce it? And how much money are you willing to invest?
Let's call it OMG.
OMG Insider?
Oh, Monsters Good. The OMG show.
How about LOL, Lords of...
Leaping.
Lycanthropy.
That's licorice.
That's werewolf. Lords of Licorice.
Yeah.
There was a Lord Licorice.
Lords of the Larynx.
What's your...
It's about a group of people who live on a giant's throat.
That sucks.
Let's go hunting for velociraptors, carve out their windpipes, and make whistles out of them like Jeff Goldblum.
Do your fans watch the show?
No.
They don't watch it?
No one's ever been a part of this. This is the biggest disaster I've ever perpetrated on the human people.
Well, you do this when you ask me. I don't know what you expect.
No, this
but
is
the guy
it
who
is.
Drove me on the fucking air. I don't know what kind of quality control you have going on.
Yeah, no. I
can't believe
I feel bad when a comedian's in the room and they're not on my, you know, you should have told me he was coming. I could have promoted him. But you wanted to make it all about you. See, you're one of these guys who steals all the limelight. And then when you get a special feature.
It's a full length feature. It's a full length feature.
What's a full length feature?
75 minutes.
Yours is 74.
But didn't you say it was 74 minutes?
With the fucking credits, it's 75. Yeah, because we had to go
no,
to film festival.
No, runtime includes credits.
Well, then they fucked up, because it's supposed to be 75 minutes.
So it's a short.
No, it's not a short. It's 75
Guys,
minutes.
Check out Eric Meyer's comedy short. Dopeless Romantic. It's almost a full length, guys, but it is a short.
It's a full length feature.
If you just don't go by the definition of what a full-length feature is, it is a full-length feature.
Oh, God.
So, but it is a comedy short. You're going to want to check that out. If you have a couple minutes, you can watch the whole thing. It's a short. And it's all on YouTube for free. I think it's 9 minutes. So, you know, let him know how he's doing in comedy. Tell him if he's doing good.
Oh, Christ.
And tweet at him. So, but it's 74. I'm just fucking with you. I don't know why it matters.
It's 75 minutes.
I'm just jealous of it. I want to get like somebody to film.
You're so horrible with these calls. They call up, you're like, hey, and then you just keep talking. You don't ask them any questions or anything.
Oh, because they're just regulars. Like, I know these idiots.
Oh.
Except for that Gussie chick who clearly doesn't have her mind on straight.
Can I have a sticker?
I mean, is this the appropriate time for that? I mean, can we give out merch and take photos later?
Nobody likes onions. Where'd you get that name?
I mean, I don't know if this is appropriate to be discussed on my 958th show.
All right, so I'm your guest. Aren't you going to ask me questions?
Yeah, I was going to.
Go ahead.
But, you know, you've got the timing of a... What's something with the bad timing?
I don't know.
God, I got to get better at this. I don't want to...
This drink's making me loopy. What is it, heroin in here? I'm seeing double.
No, it's energetic.
It's brain tonic.
Are you feeling bubbly?
Is there caffeine in here?
No.
There's no caffeine.
It's all natural.
Is that really?
What the fuck, man? Does anybody listen when I talk?
I feel really
bad. I didn't know it had caffeine. I figured you said energy drinks. So I figured caffeine.
I know.
I can't have caffeine.
No one listens to
though.
Me. I said it's all natural.
Whoa!
17 times.
It's good.
I thought caffeine was natural.
Well, what are you talking about?
It's bad.
That doesn't mean not natural. You know, marijuana is bad for you, and that's all natural.
Well, shucks.
No, it's not.
What do you mean it's not?
It's not bad.
Oh, really? Like rolling a plant up in paper, lighting it on fire, and breathing in the fumes is healthy?
Hey.
All right, there's some drawbacks.
Yeah, no shit. Anytime you're ingesting smoke into your lungs.
Yeah, you got to do something.
Yeah, you got to get it. You do have to do something.
My nana used to say,
do
something.
I love marijuana, and if you have some, we'll be happily smoke it when the show's over. The point is...
Why'd you take 2 days off?
Oh, God. Hear that?
That sounds good.
No,
that's a Walter White death rattle. Jesus Christ, I'm a lunger. I sound like Doc Holliday.
We watched that the other day.
We watched that the other day.
God, how good is that movie? People underestimate that movie. Tombstone?
Ain't that
can I ask you guys both a question?
Fucking Western ever made.
Ain't that
Pat, can I ask you a question?
No,
yeah, fuck off. Really?
Better than Back to the Future 3?
Okay, he's out of the... Do you think
he's out of the pod? Is that what you're saying?
No, my question.
How did we lose the cameras again,
Patrick?
Well,
can I ask your opinion
for the rest of the program?
Can I ask your opinion though?
If that wish you wouldn't.
If that movie would have got released, let's say in the last couple of years, do you think Val Kilmer would have got like a Best Supporting Actor?
He should have. He damn well.
I don't even think he was nominated for that role. Like, are you?
You know Val Kilmer's middle name is Trex.
Trex Kilmer?
Shut the fuck up.
Val Trex Kilmer. Oh! What do you mean?
Well, because you think...
I say I'm not a good comic. I say I'm not funny. That way, when I lose, it's like, oh, of course.
You say negative things because you're afraid if you say positive things, they don't come true. You'll get hurt.
Are you
so
afraid?
You're
afraid of success?
Me?
No, that's what you're saying, though? It's almost like a fear of success?
It's not even success.
Self-sabotage?
It's a mind thing where if you think negative things are going to happen, then
no,
you're
no, but I want to think positive things are going to happen. I just want to think negative things are going to happen to other people. hear me out. I'm in a comedy
not
competition.
Me though, right?
No. We're not up against each other. I'm in a comedy competition with these losers, okay? Robert Dean, some fag in New York who wears these little tight sweaters, okay? I get it. Pussy, okay? Let me get the camera.
I like this.
Let me go down the list here. Tone Bell. Okay, black guy. Maybe you haven't noticed, we already have an Obama. So you're fucking out. Preacher Lawson. Okay, we've seen it. Jumping around, whooping the stool with your shirt. Hello, Richard Pryor. Seen it. Non-do. I don't even fucking know you, but I can tell you this much. You're non-do very well in this contest. Kirsten Alberts, a girl? Okay, that's the millennium we're living in. Mike Spienberg, hey, hate to tell you, but we already have a Larry the Cable Guy. Seen it. Dan Dakotas, if you had a roommate and his name was Eric Myers, nothing you do can be good. Chris Cubis, oh, the guy with the hair? Hey, Reggie Watts called. He wants the whole all of it back. We fucking get it. AJ Finney might be the only other person who deserves to be in this competition. Midwestern type dude. Think he's very funny. But you go by the name AJ. That sounds like the guy my dad hangs out and buys porn with. So when you boil it down, Comedy Central, Patrick Melton, your clear and only choice for your Fort Lauderdale final. Thank you. Now, see, that was fun. And if any of those people see it, they have, like, no one's going like, what a fucking asshole. That's just some healthy.
I am in shock.
That's healthy confidence. That's healthy confidence. You blow up a little bit.
I don't
you go
stand
like,
by
I'm,
those comments.
You were getting what I'm saying. Well, you should be confident and be like, I'm going
to
take this.
Yeah, you have to walk into that contest.
But you're
thinking,
walking in
I'm
like,
the best.
I'm just honored to be here. Let's all have a good game.
Well, no, that's the fucking.
You're walking down the row of T-ball after the game where you slap hands. Good game.
That's
good
like
game,
a Tom Brady press conference answer. I'm just happy to be here. But in your head,
you have to
go,
have your game
I want to fucking win this. Otherwise, I shouldn't be here. If I don't think I'm good enough to compete, then why am I competing?
Well, I do want to win, but, you know, big an asshole. Is not going to help me.
That's not being an asshole. You're being confident.
That's just
you got 12
years
in this.
You would agree. You've no got one, more. You would agree. No comic's going to hear that and be like,
you know me comics on this list?
Like, it was fun.
I'm not saying what you just did. I'm saying I'm not walking in there and be like, I'm going to kill all these motherfuckers.
No,
I think you should.
Have that thought in your head.
You know
though.
What I'm going to do? You and know I, what my move's going to be?
My jokes are going to go over or they're not. It doesn't matter what other people do. I mean, whether or not the judges like me is
you know what
my
move's going to be? I'm walking in there with like 2 or 3 cans of that compressed air.
Yeah.
With the straws already in the nozzle.
Yes.
Turn them upside down. I'm going to go around giving people frosty enemas.
Yeah.
Frosty enema. What will throw you off before a show? Like cold up your ass.
That'll just.
I'll show you.
Why not
goddamn
just food
bone.
Poison?
That'll just
comedians.
Light a fire in my ass.
Just feed everybody bad shrimp.
Also, people.
Bad
are,
shrimp.
Are you driving up the day of?
What? We're leaving after the show.
Oh, for the next
so
week?
Hyped.
You're
yeah.
going to get there?
Yeah, me and Chris.
You're going to do some street team stuff for the week?
We'll be living on a fish barge in the bay until
the I might go up there. It'd be a good competition.
You're not staying with me.
No, I don't want to.
You and Chris and me in a room?
Him and I are probably going to stay together, and you're going to have to find a place.
God bless you. You guys stay together.
Where are they putting you up at, San Francisco?
The Sheraton Wharf.
Oof. I got it. I'm in that Hard Rock. In that Anna Nicole Smith Hard Rock.
Oh, shit.
I think definitely Fort Lauderdale got the nicest hotel out of the deal.
Oh, that's the Hard Rock in Fort Lauderdale?
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Are you at the casino?
Yeah,
at the
man.
Central Casino.
It's the Fort Lauderdale Improv, baby.
Oh, fuck.
Gamble player.
That's
you've done,
nice.
You've done that club. It's a nice club.
I headline that shit, motherfucker.
Wait,
I've headlined that shit.
No, you have.
You were in, Pat, night? You were in Orlando.
So
when
did
you, won.
You.
Thursday. You were Wednesday.
No, I've like, headlined a Thursday there.
No.
And a late Saturday and a Sunday.
Bullshit.
And an afternoon show for Joel. Yeah.
You did not headline a Saturday.
Dude, I've worked those clubs a million times. Miami, West Palm, Fort Lauderdale, Orlando.
Who are you again?
You fucking know me.
This guy couldn't MC fucking...
couldn't
MC coconuts.
I beat comedians like Jim Choquette, Tony God, Johnny B. None of these are... You know Tony God?
I do.
I love Tony.
He was here last week. He stayed with me for a week.
Tony's my boy.
He smoked all my weed and left. The minute it was gone.
Yeah. What's that?
God, it's just the old Tony.
How long is this podcast? Am I sleeping here?
No, we're going to go. We're going to go.
Okay.
We're going to get out of here.
I don't know how long I could be not funny for.
Oh, I think you're nailing it.
Can I have these glasses in the helicopter?
No, do you know who I bought those off of? A black lady at the grocery store.
Off her face? Like she was wearing them?
Well, you would think.
Horrific.
No, she was selling them outside for like some charity, but look at them closely. Like, it's like some kid made them. There's glue all over them, like on the glasses part. Like, they're not usable as any kind of actual.
Just a prop.
They're made in Taiwan.
But here's what happened. No, I think that's the black girl's name who made them. Yo, what up? It's Taiwan.
I make these in my pussy.
Do you know black people can have the like names that nobody like? They have Debris. Like, that's a black name. Debris.
Debris?
Yeah, that means literally garbage.
That's
but
racist.
It sounds nice.
That's racist, Patrick.
No, that's language.
You white piece of shit.
How is it racist to say debris means garbage?
I don't know, but it is.
Listen, she was selling all these sunglasses outside the store.
Was she hot?
In the same way that Nell Carter's hot.
Mm. I'll take a piece of that.
She was selling glasses. I'm like, give me a break. And I walked over to her table.
These references are going back a day or two.
And
there was some dust on that one.
I knew that I paid too much attention to them as I was walking in. I stayed and looked at them too long.
Wait, I want to do my facts of life routine real fast. That's where I'm going to give me.
Do you do a? I do a really good Mrs. Garrett.
Do you?
Yeah.
Do indulge it. Me.
Oh, girl.
That's pretty good.
Who was on that show? It was Blair.
Tootie. Natalie.
Which one was the lesbian? That didn't know it. She worked on motorcycles all the time, but she was hot.
Joe.
Joe, Nancy, man. I used to have the biggest crush.
Natalie.
She dated Michael J. Fox. in the 80s.
Who? God. Joe?
Nancy Keenan.
Really?
McKinnon? McKinnon? She was in the movie Poison Ivy.
Tracy Keenan.
Tracy Kaden?
Tracy
Kaden?
Yeah.
Oh, that fucking keyword.
If there's a worse comic in the world, I haven't met it.
Oh, I've worked with worse than
that's
that.
That's fucked up. Don't say
I've worked worse.
Come on.
Don't say that. That's fine.
You know just as well as I do.
She's
there are
a
these,
sweet lady.
There, yeah, but there's these people in Florida who like are on this hotel lobby circuit.
You think people headline Groucho's by accident?
No, they need $75 from a man who's almost dead.
Hey, Larry Silver has one room left in this world.
Does he have one room left?
Yeah, so
no,
what was the worst club you ever played?
Everybody gets really weird about like talking about comics. It's like that woman plays parodies on a keyboard, and I'm not going to sit here and act like she's a comic.
What is the worst comedy club you ever played?
Tracy Kanan.
What's the worst comedy club you ever played?
The one Tracy Kanan was at last week.
Oh, God. You're an asshole.
No, but, like, come on.
No, we could sit here and go all day. I mean, majority of the comics...
There is a sick circuit of Florida comic, and I don't think
no, you're right.
Fault,
the guys that work Coconuts, like, Grouches, all that shit,
they play
all
those
suck.
Rooms, like, every 3 months, they play the same room.
Yeah.
And they just do that circuit,
Steve
and that's
Eric.
How they make their living, and it's like, come on, man.
Guys like Steve Erik.
It's like you have a headshot from the 80s, your act is from the 80s, you were doing the same jokes when I started comedy, and you're going to fucking like pretend that you're a thing? You do Holiday Inns and cry yourself to sleep. I mean, let's
that's
fucking...
That's
why is that I don't know how guys like that make a living, though.
I didn't even say a name.
Patrick, how do these
he
guys...
He just listed half
that's who
I don't give a he fuck. I'm Steve Erik.
No,
that's
you're
what
right.
I said.
Valerie Storm's crushing it.
Erik DeReese. Guys that I started when I came up with. My home club was at Coconuts and Games.
Erik fucking cringe. I love it.
Do you know how many
nobody
shithole fucking headliners
show.
I've seen? Jesus Christ.
I miss good old fucking any stage, motherfucker. Let's go. Because people talk too much shit now. And it's like, you know you play a keyboard, right? And sing like Benny and the Jets. Like, that's not...
Leave her alone. What'd she do to you?
It's what she's doing to Elton.
He has a good point there.
I bounce a lot of checks. Fucking die. What are you doing? That's not comedy.
Is that one of the songs?
Yeah, it's like all the same shit. What is that one of
the
songs?
Can we change the subject? How comfortable do you want to make? What's the worst comedy?
If you like burritos and nachos.
Yeah.
I could put out an album of parodies by this afternoon.
And Cuban sandwiches and plantains.
My rice has got olives.
Yeah. Boy, that's talent.
I got hot sauce on my brain.
God, she just films herself singing karaoke, and now we're supposed to believe it's an act. Good point.
Is this show about us or ripping on Tracy?
Should I mention I slept with her?
Did you really?
No.
Did you really?
No.
You would.
Probably.
Have you ever fucked a comedian?
Oh,
yes.
God.
I fucked a few females.
No, I don't fuck dudes. I'm saying there are no women. Coming.
I've had sex with two female comedians, and one of them was an open micer. And I don't think she knew it was happening.
Yeah? She was an open
micer. I met this open micer, and the other one I won't
Janine
mention.
Janine Garofalo?
Yeah. I'd fuck her, obviously.
Really?
Yeah, because I'd try to get her pregnant and get a money. Can't
for
paycheck
the story.
No, I fuck this open micer. It's not even really a good story. It's just we got drunk, hooked
if
up.
If it's you having sex, there's no way it's a good story.
Listen here, I got some video to show you. It was
worse and worse.
Yeah. Who was it filmed by? A Google satellite?
It's just a picture. It's my camera phone. All you see is my balls for 20 minutes.
Oh, my God.
20 minutes.
Tape it to your cat's head.
Oh. But yeah, she's some open micer.
Did you know that technically we're on a Comedy Central tour?
What?
The Comedy Central Up Next stand-up tour.
They're touring America.
Yeah, we're on a Comedy Central
tour.
How
many fucking tweets do you have on this thing?
All of them.
Give me a break.
That fat guy sucks. I'm sure I keep on getting hit.
Do I have any tweets?
No. You don't have anybody who knows about you.
Are you going to tell your fans to follow me?
Erik Myers Comedy, Erik Myers Comedy,
yes.
On Twitter.
You thought I was hilarious today.
You know what? Today only, all your tweets that you make to @CCStandUp, to @ComedyCentral with #CCUpNext, mention both me and Erik, just to make him feel better.
Why not just mention me?
Well, I'm the guy.
Why waste your time on a sinking ship? Just
is that
go
a fat
over
joke?
For Tracy Kanan.
Is that a fat joke?
What? I think you should write some song parodies and just stick to Chuckles in St. Pete.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm working on Chuckles this week. You need to shut the
come on, we'll do a song parody right now. Give me a tune.
Let's do some Journey.
Journey? Lying beside you in the dog park.
Or like, you know, now that I'm getting older, can't stop my peeing.
That is good.
Huh?
That was
cool. The Depends song. I don't know why you're clapping like that. That's like her half her shit we've done today.
Yeah, she's going to be upset. We're hacking her.
God. I enjoy what I enjoy.
Who else is great?
Me?
Are we talking about like really Florida headliners like my brain we hate? Has been good. Florida headliners
it's
we
a,
hate?
It's a good stuff.
I feel like my brain is good. What is this?
Well, I'm glad we're all set, and I'm glad we had a good conversation today. You know, we had a healthy,
cathartic.
I love you. I love you.
I hope when this contest blows over,
do you want to make
we
out?
We can still be friends.
Patrick, let me explain.
I want to have you come on here one time and tell some drug stories.
Are we out of time?
We can do some after show.
What?
Smoke some weed.
No.
Blow it in his face.
I can't do that.
I gotta live with in the fucking...
Can't blow it in his face? Why?
He lets me get away with enough of it.
Do you ever like tell him he doesn't need drugs to be happy?
No.
No. I mean, we live together and I understand he's recovering.
Do you ever look at him and be like, God, I wish I had some drugs to be happy?
No.
God, do you ever like want just... Sometimes I see a guy doing crack and I just want to... Like, he smokes it, and I want to, like, chew off his neck pipe before he exhales just to get all that goodness in me.
Have you ever smoked crack?
Have you smoked crack?
Pat, what's the hardest thing you've done?
The show. No, I've never smoked crack.
Mm. You done coke, though?
No. Yeah. Oh, please, yeah. I do. I roll around in coke.
Please.
Why would you? Look That's not me. How it's done.
Look at me. I do. I got a coke body.
He fun dips the coke, honey.
Ugh. Oh, I do. God, why don't they make that fun dip out of coke anymore?
They should.
They did when I was a kid. Or maybe that's just how my dad moved
I
product.
I haven't done coke in like 3 years.
Dad, fun dip is that crazy?
Yeah.
I ate the stick.
Just rubbing the stick on your gums.
Do you want to ask me some drug story?
Gum dip. Yes. Tell me a drug story question.
Do you want to hear a drug story?
You stopped doing drugs when? You like when did you like you went? Here's the thing, you were in Florida for a while. You went away.
Mm-hmm.
Like all I knew was like Eric Myers is not doing comedy. He went away.
I was doing comedy. I went away to Virginia. Actually, I don't want to tell these stories. Fucking move on. These are depressing.
They're depressing.
Yeah, they're depressing.
I feel like they're cathartic. Isn't it like?
No, not for me.
Oh God, you just were like, ask me some things. Let's do this.
Because I thought it'd be good. Then you brought up that visual of me moving back to Virginia and it was freezing cold.
Oh, yeah, because you moved up north for a while.
Yeah, it sucked.
Because it was cold?
I don't have a car. I got to walk everywhere. It was cold as fuck. Ew. And I moved from fucking the beach in Florida, which I love. I hate the cold.
Yeah.
And it just was, it sucked. I moved mostly because of
breakup. You did what drug? What drugs were you into?
Sleeping pills, Xanax, alcohol.
Sleeping pills?
Mm-hmm.
Like what?
Lunesta.
Flintstones.
Andy. Tunnel PM.
Does that shit make you crazy like they say? They say like you can just take Lunesta like prescribed it and you'll get up and like drive to a Baskin Robbins and eat them out.
It affects different people differently.
Is that a...
No, I was taking like 30.
Well, it brings out like whatever you're into.
No, people sleep eat. They sleep eat. They go to like Taco Bell and eat and shit.
How do you literally
drive
when you're not conscious?
Asleep. Yeah.
I don't know.
Like because they That's there was a like question. A case of like a guy like killing his... girlfriend or something on Ambien or some shit.
What?
And like he was found not guilty because he wasn't aware that he was even fucking doing like they say like honestly your brain is asleep but your body's awake. And I'm like, so how are you getting a knife?
Yeah, but how does your motor skills? I mean, yeah, my body's awake.
Because I guess your visual cortex and everything is more physiological than
neurological,
like
okay.
Neurological.
Because you do stuff in blackouts. Like
it's all muscle memory.
I've
like walking.
First of all, I've
muscle,
never
like
been blackout drunk in my entire life. I've never been like blackout drunk or high. I've never been so fucked up. I was
well,
out of my
faculties.
That's
the beauty of it. You wouldn't remember.
Well, no, but I'm saying is I've never gotten that drunk or that. You can't
what
blackout
drunk.
What if
I just had videotapes of you doing crazy shit you didn't know about?
I'd be so scared.
Bring her in, guys.
You rape me.
Turn on the monitors.
No, but I mean, yeah. I mean, like your body, I guess, knows how to walk. I guess it knows how to fucking get a knife. It knows.
That's crazy. I'm
that it can't walk into walls. Like if your eyes are processing that that's a wall, I don't know. But yeah, it seems it's like your brain deep. Would have
yeah,
to be.
Sleeping pills are dangerous.
People are driving and they're not conscious.
Yeah.
How though? I mean, that's
that
just,
seems insane.
It seems impossible.
You could go, I've driven home in a total blackout.
It's like the video.
Now, that's the one thing I have done. Like, I've driven for like 15, 20 miles and like kind of came to and was like, was
I? Or you missed your, you're like, oh
yeah.
Shit.
Yeah, I missed my exit.
If yeah, I but take, everybody does that. That's a normal thing, I think.
My doctor told me if I take Ambien with the heart medication I take, I won't wake
it's
up.
It's over.
It's, yeah. Well, I got this thing.
What the fuck is that?
I had an aneurysm about 2 years
God,
ago.
God, everybody brags.
Well, no, I'm just saying, like, I took...
That's your future, buddy.
No, that's insane.
Yeah.
So you had to be cracked open your chest and everything.
They had to save my life, yeah.
Yeah.
I was dying.
Ooh.
I was out the fucking door, and they...
So you do a lot of coke.
No, it was just being no overweight shit. And genetic predisposition, but if I take Ambien... And I chase it with my heart medication. My heart rate will just.
Were you bigger? Are you losing weight?
I've lost since my since my surgery. I've lost about probably 45, 50 pounds.
Since your heart surgery?
Yeah, it's not as much as it should be. I got down. I'm 3 even now. I got down to like 270. So I lost a total of like almost 65.
Dude, I lost 45. I put it all back on this year. It's so bad. I was
it's
so fucking down.
It's so tough to lose weight, dude.
In March, April, I was down. I was down. And I was killing it. And
the thing is, you're also like 6 foot, what, 5?
Well, that helps, yeah.
I'm 5'9". So when I tip them 300 pounds, like, you don't look at them like, well, I fucking feel it.
Yeah.
You know, if I was 6, if I was your height, 3 is not that big of a deal.
That's the other thing, too. Like, you don't, I think fat people don't know what it's like to feel good. Like, it's a very,
the lowest I ever got down to is like 210.
I'm a, like, look, I'll never be tiny like you.
Yeah.
But me carrying around this weight, like, I've never known what it's like to be a normal size. And, like, you don't realize the back pain and the, like, so when I was losing that weight.
Oh, what's your knees feel like?
And I started lifting. I never lifted in my life. So I started lifting. I was doing legs. I was doing everything. And I started, to, like, after 3 months, you start seeing the muscle. And you're just like, oh, okay. And then I was like in the shower, like just, and I would feel like muscles in my chest and back that I never felt.
Yeah.
Dude, I've never felt my body
feel great
like
though.
That.
When you work out and
yeah,
shit.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. But it's, dude, like,
it's I'll tell you what though.
Put it all back on.
It's hard work.
Man. You know what though? You just got to get back into that routine.
But it is like, I think fat people don't understand. Like, it shouldn't be like to get up and move, it shouldn't be a thing. Like, you know what I mean? Like,
oh, you know what? The worst thing was I was fat. You ever do this? The Rock.
When you were fat?
Well, you know what I mean? I'm like, when I was heavier.
Yeah, tell me about the good old days in the past.
You know what I mean? When I was heavier.
Back when we were huge.
I would have to do this rolling thing where I'd have to like roll to sit up.
Called getting out of bed.
Yeah. I mean, even
hold
sitting,
on, you had to roll to get, I've never been that bad.
Well, I mean, like if I was sitting in an awkward position, like I'd have to.
Why
like,
were you sitting in an awkward position?
I don't know. Sometimes you just get in those awkward positions. You do.
Can I use your bathroom real fast?
No.
I didn't know the show was going to be
we're taping.
Yeah, we're going to get out of here, actually. No, no, let's wrap it up first. Let's wrap. We do like 90 minutes to 2 hours. I don't
really?
Know
that's
why
a,
it's
do you really?
A, yeah. 3 days a week. You know, we
really? You do? I'm sorry, Pat. I didn't know. That's crazy.
I don't need this.